Okay, we're going to discuss here the common angles that you're going to find on the SAT test. So, the nice thing is if you forget any of this information that's on this page, they basically give it to you at the front of every math section, in that box that comes with all those equations, okay? So you don't necessarily need to memorize it, but it is nice to know so you don't have to keep flipping back, for these simple relationships, okay? So the first one we'll go over is lines. Any number of angles on a line add up to 180. So here x plus y will equal 180. In triangles, the three angles of a triangle all add up to 180, right? If you ever forget this, I would say think of an easy triangle, like a 45, 45, 90, right? Add those up and they equal 180, okay? Now, quadrilateral. A lot of people forget this one too, but again, you can think of an easy one like a square, which has 90, 90, 90, 90, and add those up and you should get 360. Now, the trick comes when you have a more complicated shape like an octagon, right? That's what I have here. And I'm trying to figure out what do the angles of an octagon add up to? Well, I think the easiest way to do this is to basically draw triangles in your shape, right? So start from a point and draw as many triangles as you can. Okay, so here I'm gonna draw triangles to every basically vertice here, and I get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 triangles, and I know that each one of these triangles has angles that add up to 180. So that's just 6 times 180, which is 1080. All right, so I know that the angles of an octagon add up to 1080. All right, so that's a trick you can use if they give you a much harder shape. All right, now let's go to circles. All right, the angle of a circle, so basically starting at one point and going all the way around, right, is an angle of 360. Okay, so that's circles. And the last thing you have to know is vertical angles. So vertical angles are the angles that are created when two lines cross each other in an X, right? And vertical angles in particular are the ones that are across from each other, right? So in this case, X and Y will be vertical angles. They're across from each other. And W and Z will be vertical angles because those are across from each other. So what you need to know is that vertical angles are equal. So x will equal y because they're across from each other, and w will equal z because those are across from each other. Okay, so those are all the angles that you will need to know for the SAT.